pumper 4-1, please answer.
Thank you for joining us for this KCPT special report. I'm Cynthia Smith. Where were you on November 29th, 1988? If you were living here, chances are you remember being awakened in the middle of the night by the sound of a powerful explosion, an explosion that still sends shockwaves through this city.
Just before 4 o'clock that morning, firefighters from companies 30 and 41 in Kansas City, Missouri, responded to a call at a construction site near 71 Highway and 87th Street. The site was along what is now Bruce R. Watkins Drive. A semi-truck and trailer were on fire there. The 6 firefighters had no idea the truck was filled with ammonium nitrate used for blasting at the site. When it exploded at 4:07, it left a crater 40 feet wide and 6 feet deep. Windows shattered in a 10-mile area. People heard the blast 40 miles away. All 6 firefighters died instantly. Thomas Fry, Captain Gerald Halloran, Robert McCarnan, James Kilventon Jr., Luther Hurd, and Michael Oldham. Last week, a jury found 5 people guilty of setting the fire that caused their deaths. Now, Richard Brown, Darlene Edwards, Brian Shepard, Earl Skip Shepard, and George Frank Shepard wait for a federal judge to determine their sentence.
It was the worst firefighting tragedy in the history of our city, and this evening we're taking a look back to find out how it changed the process of fighting fires, and we'll also find out more about the trial itself, a trial that resulted in a guilty verdict for all 5 defendants. Joining me in the studio, a member of the defense team, attorney John P. O'Connor, United States Attorney Stephen Hill, Tom Jackman of the Kansas City Star, and Charles Gray of WDAF Radio. Gentlemen, thank you all for being here. The verdict was a long time in coming following a lengthy investigation that involved local police, the FBI, and ATF agents. 2 of the attorneys involved closely with the case, John O'Connor, who defended Brian Shepard, and Stephen Hill, U.S. Attorney for Western Missouri. And Steve, let me start with you. Why did it take so long for this case to come to trial?
Well, a lot of the leads dried up. We presented the case to the grand jury when we finally had put enough leads together to think that we had evidence of a crime. But it was a tough case. A lot of the evidence that that you would normally have was destroyed with the explosion.
What is the theory of what happened prior to the explosion? We had security guards going for donuts, and there was a fire set in one of the trucks. Tom, what is the believed scenario at this point of what happened that night?
I don't know. I think that we need to ask Steve that. I told you I'd throw one to you, Steve. It's yours.
Well, I think one of the problems you're going to have with this case is the case was based mostly on circumstantial evidence. It was a great deal of it was based on what the defendants said themselves. Paul Becker of our office, who tried the case, I think one of the last things he said to the jury is, why would they say this if they didn't do it? And that was a recurring theme of our case. And Tom has an article last Sunday that there's a lot of questions that will go unanswered. I'm not sure we'll ever get at some of the answers. And the purpose and the focus of the trial was not to answer some of those questions. There's going to be some questions for a long time that probably will go unanswered in this case that we'll never know the answer to.